Hallelujah, salvation and glory, honor and power to the Lord our God. Hallelujah, salvation and glory, worship and praises to the Lord our God. Hallelujah, salvation and glory, dominion and reverence to the Lord our God.
Wonder lifter of my head, you pick me from behind and put me ahead. Push me up, set my feet on higher ground. Oh yeah, Baba, turn me around. Give my testimony and say that for your grace, level don't change. Oh Baba, oh Baba, like it's a na 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 Baba, oh Baba, like it's a na na.
I said it, definitely the best a cappella group, or Afropella, as it's been coined by A Cappella Books, and they joined me in a, I'm kind of sandwiched in between them. So just to reintroduce
you. You're part of us, don't you think?
Huh? What's that? You know, yes, I could be the only female member.
Yeah.
Let me just reintroduce the group Alabaster Boss to you. There is Samuel Nyako Dowina. And are
please,
you?
I'm a girl. The name is Nako.
Nako Dowina. I'll try my best
my
with my
dad
accent.
Will not be happy with you.
Don't worry. Most people butcher my name too. So, yeah, you'll be so Abba Brazy. We've got Gideon Alote.
Yeah.
We also have Horst Ayub. And last but not least, Michael Alotene.
Exactly.
Both, everybody is here. Thank you guys for coming on.
Thank you.
I mean, your name is so synonymous, at least when it comes to a cappella. You're the name, you're the first name that comes up in Ghana for so many years. And right, there's been a lot of, so many years. I see the grays coming now.
And today, you know, when we went to the makeup room, they made up my head.
It's okay.
My head, like
it's wisdom now. It's wisdom. So where have you guys been? We know you're usually traveling around the world, performing for the likes of the Queen of England and so forth. But when you're not doing that, what else has been going on with you?
Yeah, we just returned. When I say we just returned, it's been a couple of months now. Returned from a trip in the UK.
Yeah.
We've been able to, as it were, launch our album, but in England only.
Okay.
So we are preparing to launch our album in a couple of months. We're preparing for a trip in Nigeria.
To Nigeria.
Apparently, the song we just did.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Or just
this song.
One.
Oh, okay. Just, yeah, they love it. They love it in Nigeria. So
back in Nigeria,
we're going back a second trip.
You just made a wave. So
nice. So let me ask. In terms of a lot of artists, whenever we have artists on, everybody wants to make it international. Whether it's, you know, Afro pop, they're doing high life, hip life, whatever. Mm. But you guys have been international for a long while.
Say it again.
You guys have been international for a long time.
That's nice.
But it's true. I mean,
I
saw you guys were in England. I actually remember the first time I saw you perform. Okay. You've been pretty much to almost every continent, I'm guessing.
That's right.
Yes.
Yeah.
And does that international badge, does it mean anything? Especially doing the kind of brand of, the style of music you do, which is not the most popular per se.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, for us, you know, they say music is universal. It's a universal language. I don't know what they say. Yeah, and we realized one thing. The first time we got opportunity to travel out of this country, we were in Australia there. Very long journey. It was a Commonwealth festival, People's Festival. And whilst we were there, you know, some of the groups couldn't come. It was in 2001.
That's right.
Was it?
That's right.
And that was 9/11.
That's right.
So a lot of groups, people couldn't travel.
That's right.
So we had to stand in for a lot of groups. And we volunteered and we did it. And what we realized was that anytime we were singing, when we were singing English songs, I mean the normal a cappella, the duos and stuff, people just sat there and watched us, you know, and we finished the thunderous claps. But when we did the local songs, they just went haywire dancing. And guess what? Sometimes when we are on one stage, because they have various stages in town, in halls and things like that. So when you finish, you have to move, another group will yeah. come. Mm-hmm. When we finish and we are moving to the next stage, the people follow us and they abandon the next group.
Oh wow.
You know, because and we realized that they actually love the local stuff that we have. Mm-hmm. And so that gave us an understanding that music is indeed universal.
That's right.
Realize that people actually love what is unique about us.
That's right.
And so we said, hey, why don't we should keep this uniqueness. Because when we have been to nations, we have seen groups sing. Sometimes people sing and we watch them, we like we say in Ghana, Kwame Ahim, Amesu, Metude. You know, like, I mean, what can I sing? Because people are so fantastic. Yeah. But when we start and we sing our local stuff,
they just
go flat.
That's right.
All right,
so it is, for me, it is international.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what people mean by, I mean, we need to internationalize our, I still don't
understand. Interesting, because the two gentlemen before had a different view, so it was actually interesting to have you guys on. All right, let me ask, performing for the Queen of England, I mean, most people dream of even getting an audience with her, but to get the chance for her to see you perform, how was that feeling for you?
It was amazing.
It was surreal.
Actually, I was in there.
Yeah.
Hey, now I want to talk to you.
I've heard the story so many times. Uh-huh. You know, I mean,
it was 2003.
Westminster.
Westminster. How was that
right
feeling?
Right in front
like?
Of the Queen.
Yeah, it was good, you know, and it was a lot of tension, you know.
You can imagine.
We were able to pull it off. It was good. It was good.
Yeah. What is interesting for me at the time, because you know there was a lot of noise in the abbey at the time, because the queen hadn't come in yet. And so there was a lot of noise. So when she was about to enter, we were supposed to do our welcome song for them. So we needed to get everybody to pay attention that the queen was coming in. And so we had this rooster sound.
Horse did it.
So he went, and the whole place
was like, what is going on? I can imagine. They're like, what is this?
I mean, it was a spiritual moment for us, because we realized that we just caught everybody's attention. The place went dead silent when they heard that sound. And so you can imagine, I mean, that was a moment, I mean, a day for, I mean, Ghana's glory.
Wonderful.
It was a glorious day for Ghana.
Honestly, I mean, our time is short, but you guys have been, for so many years, made Ghana proud on so many levels, international platform. And as you said, you're doing most of the time, your local language songs.
Yeah. Yeah.
How can I get to see you guys perform? What's going on? I know there's a performance you have tonight. Program
exactly,
tonight.
Tonight we are doing we are participating in a charity concert, the Trinity Hope Center, which is in Ayensudo, near Amina. I mean, it's a huge facility that they've put up there. We were there when they launched it in 2008, you know, and we are taking care of lots of children in that area.
Mm.
Now they have about 70 people in the house, but they are thinking of about 250 people more.
That's
so
right.
They are doing a charity concert today. They are starting a school.
Today?
At the place. No, they are starting a school there.
As well.
Coming in the next academy. So they are raising funds now to be able to buy a bus. To bus the children for the school.
But the concert is not happening in Almina.
It's not happening. So the concert is happening at Trinity Baptist Church.
Yeah. Oasis Center. Is it near IPS? It's opposite IPS.
They were now UPS.
UPS.
Opposite UPS, the engine filling station.
That's
there.
Right.
They are right behind them. And we are there at 6 p.m. tonight. Alabaster Boy is on the bill. OJ is on the bill.
OJ.
Becky Bonnie. On the bill.
Oh, wow.
And then some other kids from the
Spirit of Inspiration.
Spirit of Inspiration, the church choir.
Yeah.
Exactly.
What time is it starting tonight?
6 p.m. tonight.
Okay.
The admission is free.
It's free.
Totally free.
Free.
It's free. And Alabaster Box is there.
See, the Queen of England has to pay to see them perform, but you guys get to
see
them. All right, we're out of time. I want to say thank you.
Thank you very much.
Continue to make us proud. Continue to do your brand of music. Lastly, are you proud of the new groups coming up who are trying to emulate what you guys are doing?
Yes. We learned a lot of groups. And you know, we did a competition here. Is it the Zigzag Show?
Yes.
Exactly. There was a group on it. Those are
celebrations.
Those are our sons. They actually did most of the songs that they did were actually our songs.
Okay.
And please let me just say this: the Trinity Hope, the charity thing, is a 3-day thing, but we are just doing tonight.
Today.
but then Saturday and Sunday.
You can check it out tonight, tomorrow, and Sunday, and it's all free. That's right. All right, I'm going to let you guys sing us out, but before we do that, we go and end the show. The pop-up will be at 12:30 p.m. this Sunday, 20th of July, at audiences must be seated by 12 p.m. The pulpit, this is the way. And also lastly, for everybody who's going down to the Cape Coast launch of Ghana's Most Beautiful, is a pre-launch. It's happening on the 18th of July at Samrit Hotel. Also, the bash will feature popular musicians from Cape Coast and also from Accra. And the grand launch will happen on Sunday at Victoria Park at 3 p.m. So, Ghana's Most Beautiful. Have a great weekend.
Hello everyone, welcome to Asanka Delight. I'm Jackie Ankra. With love and happiness in my heart, I welcome you to the best kitchen in the whole world. Asanka Delight is brought to you by Royal Aroma Rice and Indomie. Today I've got someone in the house who's, what should I describe her as? A TV presenter, businesswoman. She says she's a model. I wonder how, she's so short. I'm taller than her. Stacy Amoateng. Hello, Stacy.
Hi, Jackie.
Well, what kind of short model are you? Or face model?
We have photo models. Sometimes you just model for certain products. So it's not about...
So do you think I could be... Could I be a model?
Yes, you can be a model. Pretty teeth? Face you.
Look at my teeth.
Perfect.
Lips?
Perfect.
Okay, how about my pose? It's lovely to have you, Stacy.
Lovely to be here.
What are you cooking for us today?
Well, I'm from the Brongahafu region.
Are you?
Yes, I am.
I didn't know that.
Yes, I am. I'm a royal from the Brongahafu region. So I need to be precise. And one of the foods we love from my part is mankeng.
I like mankeng fufu. Yeah. But today you're making ampesi.
I'm making ampesi with mankeng. And cocoa.
Plantain. Two of my favorite things.
And I'll just add a little bit of yam to it.
I like
some
yam.
People also love yam. So I'm just cooking three stuff from my region today. And I'll be doing that accompanied by assorted vegetable contomo stew.
I've never seen contomo with carrots in it.
And everything.
Okay, so why don't you run us through your ingredients? I see avocado. Yeah. Avocado's in season, so we're eating a lot of that.
And I love it with bread.
Me too. That's what I have for breakfast. That's what I have for breakfast. Okay. And it's a good source of essential fats and oils, so it's very good.
Yeah, it is. So we start with our mankeng and our cocoa. So we have our cocoa and mankeng. Cocoa is ripe plantain, and we have our yam here. For our contomere stew, we have our contomere, we have our carrots, our green pepper, our spring onion, our tomato. We also have our salmon.
Our mackerel. I was just waiting for you
to say that. The mackerel here, but sister.
Okay, sister. Okay, so. But I've never seen contomere with carrots. That's the Brongahafu style,
is it? It's not Brongahafu style. It's something that I love to do.
Your own creation.
And kids are very fun with food. So sometimes you just need the food to be a little bit colorful so that once they see, they just want to sit and eat. So I always try as much as possible to make the food as colorful as possible. Okay, then we have our eggs. We have our pepper. I always love the fresh pepper because they're the best. They're not processed. It's just real. And we have our sunflower oil, our onion, our seasoning, and our corned beef.
Okay, so we've got corned beef and mackerel, all of that going in the same dish.
All of that going in the same dish. So it's a very rich meal, something you would serve when you have guests or special moments like Christmas, Easter, when you have family coming over. And one thing, we have our garlic and our ginger.
Of course.
I love my garlic and my ginger.
And what's for dessert?
Dessert, we have pineapple and lemon juice with a little bit of ginger.
I'm a happy woman. I think I'll enjoy this experience.
Yeah, you will enjoy it.
So there I am in my kitchen having fun, still enjoying the spirit of football. Stacy Amoateng is here. She's going to run us through some Brongahafu dish, you know, something that she says will make me really excited. Stay with us. We'll be back after the break. You're watching Asanka Delight, brought to you by Royal Aroma Rice and Indomie. Look, don't worry too much about the adversaries. Once we cut up the onion, the ginger and the pepper, we shall put it in the ice and we shall score them. So no problem there. Stacy's busy. Stacy, what are you doing? Putting
my yam in.
But why have you cut the yam different shapes and sizes?
This is actually puna, and mostly when they are thin, they get to mush.
You were teaching me the three words for that too, huh?
It's huno. Yeah, so when it's bigger.
Because I've always said it to poto, I never say huno.
That's the Ghana saying.
You don't say poto in Chi.
No,
really?
No.
Oh, I've learned a new word. And this is like everybody says that. Yeah, all I can say,
yeah,
Abehuno.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So you see, my chi is not that good.
I have to learn Ga because I speak chi. I speak Ewa, but I don't.
Do you?
Yeah, but I don't.
What did you learn, Ewa?
From home, you know, my grandfather, I lived with my grandparents and he was a regional director for electricity. So every 4 years we were going to another region. So we started off with the Ashanti region, then we went to the Eastern region and the Volta region and then Central. So I lived in about 6 regions. We did the Bronga Ahafo region too, but that is like home. So home. That one wasn't
so you learned to speak the dialect in every region you went to. So you speak good Fanti.
And we're young, so, and you know, when you're young you don't really have a lot to think of. Mm-hmm. So you go to school and it was so funny. You know, when we went to the Volta region, I remember like when you're a Akan and you go there, they call you a Bluvi. So we'll go to school and the kids will just be saying Bluvi nye Balibi and we didn't even know what it was, so they'll come to you and you ask them also, you want to say how are you, how do you say it, they'll tell you Abu, and then you go to those are very I'm telling Jackie, it wasn't funny.
It was a good way to learn.
One day our vocational skills teacher came to class and I was trying to let the woman know, Charlie, I can speak
Ewa. And you said Abu to her.
And right then she realized, no, someone had been miseducated. So she was like, Anastasia, where did you learn? Where is it? Oh, it was my friend who said, how are you? Then was said, Abu. I said, no, it's F1. I said, okay. So from that time, I didn't talk to that girl in the school again. I said, you almost got me in trouble. So
oh, that's a good one.
Salt.
Okay, salt to taste. Not too much salt.
Not too much.
We shouldn't eat too much salt these days.
These days, we're all trying to be healthy because...
We are indeed.
Let me wash my hands of the salt. But our plantain is not going in now because it's ripe.
And it's softer.
So we just wait a little to let that one go in. So we're going to start working on our contomer stew. We already have our onion and tomato sliced, so I'll start with my spring onions.
This is amazing contomer.
Yeah, you would love it.
It's got all sorts of things in it. I've never seen spring onion go in contomer.
You would love it, Jackie. Like the first time, I have a cousin who normally comes to the house to visit Eno. So she saw me doing it. She's actually a caterer, so she was just standing at the door looking at me like, is this girl serious? And she was like, Nana, what are you doing? I said, watch me. It's one of my crazy ideas, but you love it.
You're called Nana at home?
Yeah, I'm Nanukia.
Well, Stacy, you used to do music, and everybody loved you when you were doing music, and then now you're doing Ghana's Most Beautiful. Are you still doing that?
Well, Ghana's Most Beautiful was last year. That's for season 7. This year they are they're doing the auditioning, so I don't really know
if you still,
if I'm gonna do it or not. But it was a lovely experience, and like you said, music. I was on music for 11 years, Jackie.
11. That's how long it was. Yeah. That's how long it was.
It was.
It didn't feel like 11.
Yeah.
It didn't feel like 11,
but it was 11. And
did you have fun doing that?
I did.
What are we going to do with the spring onions? What do you want to put
another plate?
Do you need, or you can, your bowl's here if you want to use
it.
I washed it nice and clean for you.
Thank you, darling.
Was it challenging doing music?
It was
a lot of music, wasn't it?
You know, it was just like having entertainment in school. You get to meet musicians. You get to ask them all the daring questions. And what I was
I loved doing, your interviews with the musicians.
What I was doing was mostly, I wouldn't want to know about their songs. I would, if we have an artist coming on the show, I would go to town and I would just ask people, oh, when you say, oh, never shown, so what do you know about the person? And you know, like, people really have false information out there. When you're on TV, everybody wants to portray they know you. So you get people say, oh, we are so I say. So I listen to them and I pile them up for the show. So sometimes I ask certain questions and they're like, Stacy, are you serious? You're crazy. And honestly, those were questions people were asking in town. So once I have them, I just ask them for the truth. Because there's nothing like hearing it from the horse's own mouth. Music was great, but as I was growing, because I started very young,
And on the show, I got married. I had 3 kids. And life is
full. Did you meet your husband on Music Music?
No.
No. But you haven't told us who your husband is. Look, your husband, he's confusing everybody because he used to be Ochiame Kofi. Now he's Kofi Ochiame. Why is he doing that?
It's a rebrand.
Oh, please, it's so confusing.
It's not confusing.
Because every time I want to say Kofi Ochiame,
he has a new album out, which is Higher Life Living. And it's actually bringing to bear that you don't really need to have millions of cities to live the life that you want to live. It's all up in the mind.
Okay, so that's the lot of it done. You've cut your carrots nicely. What about your yam? I can smell it.
Yeah.
I can smell your yam. I think it should be cooked by now.
Almost.
Almost.
Yeah, because the kokoyam.
The yam and the kokoyam, they take the same time? Or I think kokoyam is a lot tougher than yam.
Yes, it's a lot tougher. Almost.
At what point would the cocoa go in?
When the yam is almost done, cocoa, because it's already ripe,
and okay,
will not take a
so long. That's the way. Finished with the cutting, you're not cutting any.
Yeah. Can you help me blend the pepper?
You want to
blend
with that?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Do you like singing?
Oh my god.
One musician in the family is enough, eh?
One musician is enough, darling.
Hey!
It's enough. And I think my first daughter...
Oh, okay. There.
So we have one musician, and my first daughter is also showing signs.
How old is she? How old are your children?
She'll be 9 in September. But
how long have you two been married?
9 years.
Wow. I didn't realize 9 years had come already.
Time flies.
It does
when
indeed.
You lose respect.
Are you going to let it cook?
Yeah, I love garlic and ginger.
Me too. I don't use too much seasoning. All I use is garlic, onion, ginger. Mm-hmm. Everyone's saying, hey, she's saying she loves onion, garlic, ginger every day. She never cooks. She never cooks.
The tomato will go in now.
She likes dogs.
Not really. I'm not
people don't like dogs.
I'm not much of a pet person, but if there is a dog, fine. If there isn't, fine. I'm not really fuzzy.
I used to like dogs, but when they die, it's so heartbreaking. I don't bother anymore.
And when we're kids, we grew up with lots of dogs. We had a dog called Bullet. And we had one called Face Guy. And Face Guy was wild. Like, anybody knocks at the gate and he's there. But they, like you were saying, they all die somewhere. And sometimes it gets so worrying and it's almost like losing your best friend. So
I know, sad. So sad. So that's our onion tomato. Cover that a bit.
Yeah.
And then we do what?
So we wait a little.
And our yam, how's that doing?
Our yam is coming up well.
And our kokoyam, our yam and our kokoyam.
Yeah.
Our mankane.
My mankane. Call it mankane.
Mankane, yeah, okay. Mankane.
I will start working on my salmon mackerel. So I mostly get rid of the head. Then I'll start by peeling the skin. There's a whole surgery going on.
Oh, you're calling it surgery.
Yes, it is. Because you have kids at home. When you have kids at home, you just want to make sure you don't have bones. I've done my surgery. I have it open.
Is it hard being a mom?
No, I wouldn't say. It's a thing of joy. So you'll not be fair to say it's hard.
And you get used to it.
You get used to it with time. It's when you have your first child and you have to wake up at dawn to breastfeed, that's when it's difficult, but with time you get used to it. I remember when I had my first child.
Music.
She would be crying at night. You know what? I'll just wake up, take out the breast and hold it like that and go to sleep. And she did it for so long till she was like, I mostly do long-term breastfeeding. She breastfed for 1 year, 9 months.
daughter until she stopped breastfeeding.
Have you got anything left?
Yeah, I still have a lot left. Sometimes it amazes people when I tell them I did that long-term breastfeeding. Yeah.
Because modern people don't like that.
No, you have to. And that is actually one of the secrets of my apps. Because people are like, you don't have any stomach showing that you have kids. My gynae told me the more you breastfeed, it kind of pulls the muscles, so it's able to go fast.
Oh, now everybody will want to breastfeed.
Yeah, so it's the truth. And I tried it with all of them. Beyonce breastfed 1 year, 6 months. And it was the same. Very soon, my tummy was back in. So if you don't like to breastfeed, forget about having your abs back.
So well, why don't you check on the yam and let's see if it's...
Yeah.
I love the smell of this. Yeah. But it mustn't cook too much.
No, it wouldn't, yeah.
Oh, so that looks ready.
Well, so can you help me slice the plantain?
Okay, how do you want? Oh, you should rinse that a bit. Let me rinse that. How do you want it? Just in half or?
No, not in half. About four.
Four? Yeah. That's tiny.
Yeah.
Okay, but soft.
It's soft, so it can really boil faster.
Okay. So here's my new assignment. I'm the chopper of the cocoa. That's it. Let's see. That's one.
Yeah. Planted.
Two. Okay, there's four. Oh, this is nice. Mm-hmm. And what about your boutique? Because I remember you started them.
Yeah, Stacy's boutique.
Is that still there?
Yeah.
You should bring me some clothing.
No,
you should bring
problem.
Me some cute things to wear.
No problem.
Like it is, yeah, things. That would be nice. But some of these are tiny. Some of the, I think this one we'll get three out of this.
Yeah, so let's do three.
Mm-hmm. So there you go, nicely cut up. Shall I pour on there?
Yes, you can.
Okay. So there we go. How are we doing? Oh, nice and colorful. I see what you mean about the colorful. Mm-hmm. This is nice.
So we have,
and the spring onions are going in.
And with this dish, it doesn't really take much time.
I know if we went chatting, we'd be finished by now. Is there encomode? It's not every day that I get Pretty Stacy in my kitchen, so I have to ask you everything. And at what point is our kontomi going in?
Very soon.
Just after before we take it off.
Our mackerel and our salmon kun mackerel and our seasonings is the last thing that we go in.
The eggs? When
because
do we boil
the eggs?
We
don't want to lose the nutritional value of the kontomi.
No, we don't. Yeah. No, we don't. What about our eggs?
Our eggs will go in. That will be the last but one thing that goes in. So our eggs will go in, then our kontomi will do the final magic.
Okay, so it looks like we're not doing badly, and we're making progress. We said we were going to talk about football, but we haven't talked about football. What's your favorite football team?
In Ghana?
Better be the Black Stars.
In Ghana.
International.
Okay, that's Barcelona.
You like Barcelona?
Yeah.
Ah, I like Chelsea.
Barcelona.
I like this blue.
Blues. I don't like the blues.
Oh, well. It's a beautiful life right here on Asanka Delight, and I'm hanging out with Stacy Amoateng. I've convinced her that the best teams in the world are number one, the Black Stars, number two, Chelsea, number three, Hearts of Oak. And now it's time to eat my dinner, Stacy. Where's the food?
Coming right
okay,
up.
Dish up. But this is a lovely juice that you've got here. Let me taste it. Smoothie, isn't it? Because we blended it till it was smooth. So.
You love the ginger effect?
I should try this at home. I always do the pineapple and ginger, never the watermelon. This is nice. You've got to try this. Oh, and we put some ice in there as well, so it's super refreshing. This looks nice.
Thank you, dear.
But the carrots, you've overcooked your carrots. I can't see the carrots anymore. They disappear.
They are.
this is a lovely meal, but you have to put your drink here so I can see the sauce properly. So, well, you're going to serve, or?
Thank God you've given me.
Oh, we have to drink. We have to drink to Ghana and the Black Stars.
They should be drinking.
Long live Ghana. Long live the Black Stars. Long live you and I.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and long live Bassa.
Mm-hmm.
No, I got you.
Well, I suppose Bassa has to be there, so let them be there. Mm. I like this. I think this food is nice. We have to sing, Yenarai, Assassin, Ehaboy, the Dima, before we eat this. We have to be patriotic.
Thank I'm sorry. You,
there you go. How much?
That's our mankane.
How much? Or you want more?
No, I just want one mankane.
Do you eat a lot? Are you one of those people who eat
a
lot, but it doesn't show?
Little bits of everything. I love my food, though.
You do?
Yeah, I love my food.
Me, as soon as I eat, it shows. That's the thing I don't like. Okay, so there you go.
I have one cocoa
for you. But the cocoa is not as soft as you made me believe. Let me have a soft one for me. So there we are. Okay, so
sauce, please, just a little. And your egg.
Oh, egg again. I thought there was egg in the sauce already. Thank you. And serve yourself as well. Are we eating with our fingers or with our fork?
Ghanaian way, with our fingers.
Fingers, okay.
Because this is a typical Ghanaian food.
So bless this food, O Lord, be glorified in our lives and in our nation. Let Ghana shine forever and ever and always. Amen.
Amen.
It's a good taste, this. Let's see how this goes. The sauce, it looks a bit dry, oh. All that mackerel and corned beef and everything.
Because we didn't use a lot of oil. I told you.
That's nice, Papa.
Thank you, dear.
I love it. Stacy. This is nice. Oh, wow, and the green pepper.
And the carrots and everything.
The carrot, the spring onion. This is nice food. Ah! Stacy, I love it.
Thank you, dear.
To go with it. You're a great woman.
Thank you, dear.
May your children be as great as you. Amen. Greater than you.
Yeah, greater.
May your husband love you always.
Amen.
And may Ghana be proud of you always.
Amen, dear.
This is nice food. It's lovely, lovely food. And you, I've got to thank you for watching. You're the best audience there is. And someday, I'll arrange to bring you all in here so you can try the food, because it really is lovely food. But you can try it at home. I'd like to thank Royal Aroma Rice and Indomie, as well as Ophelia Crossland, for my lovely dress.